Hello and welcome to Future Foundation episode 57. We got a jam-packed card here tonight, and we're going to start things off in just a moment. We got some little outro things here. Going to test those out for the first time here as we start right now. Our first match, former X Division champion, former television slash US champion, Mamba, making his way to the ring here for the first time since accepting the open challenge against the world champion, Justice Stone. And speaking of Justice Stone, in our main event tonight on Future Foundation, or our final segment, I should say, of the night, Justice Stone coming to the ring to celebrate over 1 year as VPW World Champion. We'll see how that goes and what he has to say. What? The Revolt Wrestling Network champion, MVH, makes his way down to the ring. He just got announced for our Takedown Network partner, Ground Zeroes. He's going to be facing off against former tag partner here in VPW, Mike O'Connell, members of the Prologue here in VPW and elsewhere, but facing off at Ground Zero, night one. Should be a great match between those two. MVH, a man with more defenses of that Revolt Championship than any other previous holder. Two holders before him, not either of them have held the championship as long and defended as much as he has. Bell rings as we kick things off here. My computer, I think, decided not to work properly, but we'll try. Mamba gets caught with a clothesline here by the champion. Repeated clotheslines by MVH. Drops down with a senton there. Mamba reverses, gets the collar and elbow boot to the gut here as he gets him. Fisherman. Brainbuster. Has him wrapped in the ropes here as he's going to take out the knee. Smart decision by Mamba here. Possibly you did, yeah. MVH, like I said, one of the strongest Revolt champions of the three we've had. He's definitely the strongest, obviously. Jermaine Barrett, the first champion. Dante Dinsmore, the second. Mamba taking the fight to MVH so far, but again, MVH has defeated so many of challengers along the way so far. And there's that springboard into the back elbow. I don't want to undersell this at all. We do have quite a show here tonight. It is a long show. And MVH is going to make it even longer as he continues to clothesline Mamba. Bringing him to the corner here, face first into the buckle. Elbow to the face by Mamba. Not fast enough. No, wait a minute. Quickly reverse and sends the champion to the floor. Champion's going to be smart about it, get back in the ring. Even though you have that time to spare on the outside to recover, you don't want to spend too much time because, of course, as obvious as it should have already been, any time you spend recovering on the outside is recovery time for your opponent as well. Has him up on the shoulders. MVH drops down and takes the knee. Just want to say for the record as well, Mamba 0-2 in this season and MVH 4-0. Mamba has him up on the shoulders. It works this time. Guillotines him on the top rope. Takes the elbow there. Now lifts him up off the mat. Fisherman Brainbuster a second time. MVH having to get on the outside and caught with a shoulder tackle, knocking him to the floor once again. Mamba, for the second time in this match, sending the champion to the floor, but getting sent into the steps for his trouble. With a double axe handle on the outside, knocking him down into the floor. Little miscalculation there by the champ. Happens to the best of us. As Mamba using that opportunity to super kick him right in the face. And goes back to that arm. And this brainbuster has been used multiple times already, and Mamba making sure MVH is going to feel every bit of those brainbusters. MVH charges him, gets those strikes, and a big rolling elbow, not knocking him down, but busting him open in the process. Going back over, takes the knee, taking a page out of his own book. Mamba gonna snap. Oh my god, snapping the arm. The champion could be in trouble. That arm's been getting targeted quite a lot. And Mamba seems to have his target in sights properly, but unfortunately for him, he got too slow there and got caught with a DDT. Now the drop kick to make sure he stays down, and he keeps trying to fight back up to his feet, but MVH not allowing him. Sends him to the ropes here, goes for the belly-to-belly, sweeps the leg, does Mamba. VP dub. Mamba now takes over into that wrist lock, but no, MVH able to get to the ropes there. Nice forearm smashes here by Mamba, back elbow off the ropes, and a clothesline to take him down. MVH caught here as Mamba's going to take him over to the corner here. Face first into the top buckle. Overhand, no, blocks it, sends him into the corner. Big right. MVH with a big lariat out of the corner. Oh, look at the taunting from the champion. The confidence as he waits for him, charges in. Oh, knee to the face. Pulls him in for another clothesline. Oh, what an axe kick. As now MVH to the top. Can't see what he's doing because the ref's in the way. Corkscrews, moonsault. One, two, no. Only getting a two count on the corkscrew. Oh, got him now. Choke slam, headset cover. One, two, no. Once again, only getting a two count, throwing everything he had. Boot to the face by the champ as he's not done yet. Up to the top. Feast your eyes. He knocked his head off cover. Two, no. Mamba's kicking out of a lot of things here. He gets out of the way of the back elbow this time. Lifts him up. Sends him off to the ropes. Punch to the gut here. Chopping away at the big man. Overhand sends him into the ropes. Clothesline to the floor. Mamba's on a run. He's on fire right now. Tope! Suicida! And MVH just kicks his head off as soon as he gets back up. This is the fight of a champion. And not to take anything away from from Mamba. MVH tried to cut him off there, but Mamba, a little degenerate there. Degeneracy on that taunt as we see Mamba leapfrog over, punch to the torso again. A low shot, but not a low blow. Just chopping away again as MVH caught here. Hammerlock suplexes him. Mamba reverses. Caught him here, sends him into the corner himself. Clothesline's trapped in the corner. He's keeping him in there so he makes sure he can hit that final one. Now the quick cover attempted. One, two, only a two count from the clotheslines by Mamba. Drop kick to the back of the head as well. Looking to end things here. Mamba caught him here. Oh, look at this, the cross armbar. A lot of torque on the elbow here as Mamba could have submitted him. No, elbow to the face as he broke the grasp. Hits him with a back elbow again, does MVH. He's telling him to get up. He's begging him for more fight. As you see Mamba starting to drop blood in the ring here as that cut on his face is starting to really be a problem. Goes around. Neck breaker. Does not drop all the way down. He keeps him into the arm drag. Cravats the neck into the suplex. Mamba possibly trying to make him bleed as well. Mamba's no slouch. No, nothing to just throw away, disregard nothing. Mamba is a former X Division champion, and he earned that championship in a way that only one other person in that X Division title picture has ever earned it, and that's Hunter. Hunter and Mamba fought to the nail for that X Division championship, and both of them ended up getting it, but Mamba losing it to Hunter as we see him with that Fisherman Brainbuster once again, hooking the leg and getting a near fall there. Now, MVH pulls him back, uppercut. Cover attempted. Two. No, only a one count there. You see that aggression, that side of MVH we only started to see very recently. That ultra aggression style that he started to bring in to VPW. We saw some of that aggression peek through in some of his defenses on other shows, but only recently have we seen it really pull through. Mamba gets the grapple here, but he's too weak to keep a hold of him. Mamba's getting caught with elbows there. Oh, blocked it, or dodged it more so, and now MVH has him trapped in the corner. No, put him in the corner himself. Big overhand chop. Mamba now, collar and elbows him, cravat the neck, into the suplex again, but he's got so little energy left in the tank, it took a lot out of him. He tried to charge at him, but he waited for him as soon as he got in, throws him back over the rope. Mamba now has him on the apron here, lifts him up, and the suplex on the edge of the ring. MVH charges, but he's just a little short. Suplex on the outside. Both men feeling the effects of that. Mamba maybe feeling it a little bit more as you see the blood start to drip and pour all over. Oh, and he gets caught as soon as he got back to his feet. MVH playing it smart. He knows this is a low risk kind of match. He knows he could get back in the ring, not risking his championship in the slightest. Sends him to the ropes here. Drop down. Leapfrogs over. Caught him. Pop-up kick. And the knee lift to the face. Cover. One. Two. No. The quickness of those strikes as he hit that knee lift, and now Mamba's knee being targeted, as well as MVH to the top rope again. Could we see another corkscrew moonsault? No, he's calling for something else here. Oh, the Meteora! Flips him over now. Oh, stomp to the back. Wait a minute. He's got him trapped in this camel clutch. Leaning back on it. And Mamba taps out to the camel clutch. MVH picks up a win. And Mamba out of the ring already. He kicked him aside.
In VPW, MVH stands in the ring with a microphone to bless all of you here tonight and everybody watching at home as well. As you all see right now, I am the current reigning and defending RWN World Champion. And now when you look at the list of RWN World Champions that came before me, none of them really compare to the reign that I have had thus far. I have been having instant classics defending this championship, making it actually mean something. Something that the previous two failed to accomplish. So I had to step in. I had to step up. I had to make this championship mean something. I had to have this network have a champion representing them that they could be proud of. So I'm going to do what I've been doing for quite some time with this championship. At Wrestle Wars, I will be there issuing an open challenge to whoever wants a shot at this championship. Whoever wants to put on an instant classic with the fastest rising star in the industry today with a world championship on the line, all you gotta do is answer the call and walk down that ramp at WrestleWars. So to whoever it is, I wish you the best of luck, because there's not a man alive who can take this title from me. But I invite you to try, because I enjoy the competition. But you're all going to be doing a very, very familiar team. And still, RWN World Champion, MVH.
Very strong words from the Revolt Wrestling Network champion, issuing an open challenge for WrestleWars. Anyone can accept the challenge. It's an interesting reward for whoever decides to take that challenge. And if they could defeat MVH in the first place, as now we got women's tag team action as Hina Sakura and Mariah Toriyama making their way to the ring here. Gatai, I think that's how you say it. Making their way to the ring here for this tag match. Currently having a win-loss record as a tag team. 0-1. That one loss coming at the hands of Orange Crush Girls in their debut as a tag team here. Speaking of debuts, a debut of this team, Dark Before Dawn, tag team here in BPW and tag team most places, but you'll be seeing them face off against each other on Ground Zero, representing our partner, PPW. Of course, they are affiliated with the Revolt Wrestling Network. But you'll be seeing them very soon again, like I said, facing off against each other, representing PPW. Again, don't forget to check out Ground Zero. A lot of interesting matches there. But let's focus on the match that's in front of us right now. Hannah Dark starting this match off with Hina Sakura. Hina with a big kick, but gets taken down with a hip toss and smashed into the mat multiple times here. Of course, with tag matches, it's an hour-long time limit due to all of the outside factors that can come into play. Double the participants, double the time. Got Buster there. Only a count of one there. This is very early in the match. No surprise at all that only a one count there. Allie Dawn on the apron here as Mariah goes after Hannah on the apron. Caught Allie with some forearms here and a kick. Oh, double kicks. Triples. And the big axe kick to the back of the head. Or crescent kick, even. I don't know what to call it. One, two. Only getting a two count there. Face first into the buckle. Mariah now. Armbar over the rope. Right in the face of Hina. really making it hard for Ali Don to gauge, like, how to escape the hold when you have a person right in your face taunting you as you're getting your arm stretched. Caught the kick. Hand springs up. Gets caught on the clothesline. Mirai sending Ali Don into the spin kick. Beautiful heel kick there. Hina Sakura trying to get in better position to stop Ali Don and to taunt in Hannah's face a little bit. Nothing says I got one over on you like cutting your partner off and doing the move directly in the face, staring into the eyes of the opponent. Ali, Irish whip, forearm to the face after the reversal, pushes Mirai off and a boot to the face, followed by the exploder on Hina. Tag to Hannah Dark. Dark charges in and a dropkick straight to the face. House of Fire comes in, spikes the Hina into the mat, charges, misses the knee strike. Oh, ducks under the roundhouse. Hannah suplex. No, Hina drops down behind and takes out the knee. Irish whip into the corner. Nice electric chair slam there. The suplex is now Mirai getting tagged back in. Collar and elbow sends Hannah into the ropes. Spin kick lands once again, but this time on the other opponent. A sound strategy from Gatai here so far. Keep them isolated, and even if it's a little predictable, stay to what you're familiar with. Hit the moves you know, so you are guaranteed a shot. And a dark, heavily isolated. Mirai gets a hold of Dark, sending there in the buckle. Tags Hina. Hina tried to make a tag on the way over. Gets set into the knees and distracted on the way over. Oh, and a kick to the lower back. Blocks the overhand. Dark needs to get some fight in here. Fireman carry. And drops Hina on the top buckle. Going outside for a breather, comes back in. Oh, just a whiff there, but enough. Hina now exploder into the buckle. And standing directly in the path required for the tag and taunting away. Absolutely despicable behavior, but I cannot say I blame her. A very smart strategy. Stay in between you, well, between your opponent and their partner. Oh, and a big hook to the face. Hina got rocked in the corner. Hina gets the boot and the knee to the face. Charges and another boot. Dark finally getting some offense, trying to recover some momentum. Cover. Only getting a one count off of that attempt. Not much of a surprise, but of course you got to try when you can. Tag made to Don here. Double Irish whips. And a double shoulder tackle. Ali Don. Double leg takedown. crosses the legs for the sharpshooter. Oh, drop kicks Ali in the back to loosen the grip, and Mirai sweeps the leg in the process. Pulls back into the knee to the gut. Mirai and Hina have been working flawlessly as a team so far in this match. Of course, they have an immense amount of experience as a team. And from what I could tell, Ali Dawn, I believe her first match in VPW was only her second match ever. So we're at a stage for Dark Before Dawn where we got someone who's not very experienced and someone who has experience versus a team that is well-versed in this type of match. As Dawn set into the rope, nice punch to the stomach. Springboards up, misses the forearm. Dawn catches Hina here on the mat. Sends her into the corner, going to take her time. Oh, elbow to the face. Double leg takedown as Hina top mount and a palm strikes to the face. Ali needs to get out of there, and she does. Hannah Dark in the ring here. Boot to the face. Takes Mirai's head off cover. One. Only gets the one. Ali, move. You have to believe, though, with the unfortunate state of our women's tag division, winning this match could put you directly in the top rank for a shot at those championships. Hurricanrana! Hanna getting away from that electric chair drop for the Hurricanrana and gets distracted here. Ali was in the wrong position and caused the mistake there, the misstep. Mirai very wisely tagging in Hina. Hina charges into a knee strike. Both of them running straight at each other, but only one of them was throwing a knee. As Hannah Dark tags back in Ali. Oh, and a big roundhouse kick to the head. Quick cover attempted. One, two, no. Ali with another knee. Goes behind. No, half and half gets blocked with an elbow. Kicks flying. Nice suplex by Dawn. Going to allow the tag here. And she also tags Mirai and Dark in the ring. And Dark charges in with a knee to the face. On a nice headbutt. Right, using the distraction to her advantage. Big heel hook yet again. Usher up into the corner now. No tag being made as we're just going to see the armbar again. This time Hanna getting a taste of this. An armbar with your opponent taunting in your face is not ideal. Neither is just getting an armbar in general. Irish whip into the ropes, though, does Hanna, and a headbutt again. This time with a little bit more force behind it. Hanna, knee to the face. And Mirai getting right back up. What the hell? There's the Rana. Oh, plants her. Caught her as she tried to get away. Face first into the buckle now. Toss aside. Springboard Enziguri from the corner. Tag made to Hina though. Oh, the discus boot! Just took her head off. Up on the shoulders, DVD! Cover. One and Allie right there to break that one up. Takes her head off with that knee. Tag to Mirai, and Hannah getting back in after getting hit so hard that she rolled out. Oh, the knee lift again. Could this be a strategy to make Hina get out of the ring faster? Feign injury or struggle to make Mirai get tagged back in for a little extra offense. Mirai definitely has taken more damage in this match than Hina has. That could be the strategy going into this one right now. It's the suicide solution, now a cover. One, and a one count broken up there. Allie not allowing Hina to distract. Is now crosses the arms, keeps them locked into the neck breaker. Elbow to the torso. Mirai gets caught. No, other way around. Steiner screwdriver by Mirai. Cover. One, two, no. Mirai is a little frustrated. Tag in Hina, who gets caught into the wheelbarrow face buster. Beautiful suplex. Hina, though, recovers with an overhead takedown. Or a takeover, if you will. Boot to the chin of Dawn. Quick kick to the back end for her cover. Sweeps the leg, does Allie. Caught her here, spinning around into the crush. Now the suplex. We've seen Allie do that suplex. Maybe that's something Allie's picked up through just watching Hina wrestle on the apron. Now Hina, another knee to the face. Off the ropes now, rolling. Thunder lands perfectly. Tag made. Allie Dawn has the opportunity here as Hina on the mat. Crosses the legs. Another sharpshooter. Locked in place. And right there is Mirai to break up the submission. Allie Dawn a little frustrated but staying composed. Boots the knee. Heads up to the middle rope. Diving into the Canadian Destroyer. Now what is Allie thinking? From the top, the moonsault. Cover. One, two, three. A great win for them in their tag team debut. As we'll move on from here, straight into our next match, singles action underway. Taz Hendricks versus Bowen Blackwell. Taz Hendricks, we just saw him on FIC participating in that tournament that they're doing right now that I am at the moment blanking on the name of it. Sorry. Holy Grail War, round one, night four. There we go. Sorry. I won't spoil the outcome of the match. For people who have not seen it, of course, but do check it out. Taz Hendricks, though, coming into this matchup, a man who has not had a lot of exposure on VPW in recent time. But even with that, his win-loss record is 2-1. And his opponent, Bowen Blackwell, former VPW television champion. 3-3 in singles action. Last seen, similar to Mamba earlier tonight. Last seen in an open challenge against Justice Stone. Jesus Christ! The match just began and Bowen's already busted open here. Taz with an immediate strike that busted him open. Jesus Christ. And now Bowen, neckbreaker combination. Oh my, crosses the legs, he's got a hold of him. Super Dragon, oh my God, he's busted open too. They're not holding back, you could guarantee these two aren't pulling punches. Or kicks even, as Bowen from the top. Diving Meteor, nobody home. Face buster on the knee. Blackwell trying to cut him into Taz's face with any possible strike. And Taz just trying to fight away from that idea. As Bowen to the outside. Caught him with the left hook. Oh, and ducks for the right, but gets caught with a hip toss. Tried to fake him out, but he was paying attention. He kept an eye on him. Fireman Carey has him up. Wait a minute. Taz sends him into the barricade. Double axe handle connects on the floor as he continues with some punches to the face. Bowen repeated strikes, the kick to the gut, and the spine buster. As with some well-placed elbows, sending Bowen into the barricade, but not quite through it. As Hendricks going to let him get back in. If Bowen even wants to get back in after what he's been going through in this match so far. Taz is telling him to get back in, and Bowen, he's just yelling at him. Gets back in and immediately caught. That's exactly what he was worried about. Drop down by Hendricks. Big drop kick by Hendricks. Goes behind, Tiger Suplex. So as we heard earlier, MVH has that open challenge. One of these two men could accept that challenge. So we see Taz just cross-facing with those forearms, goes for the cover. Only got the one, but doesn't matter. Another big right hand there. Sends Bowen into the ropes, drops down. Drop down again. Misses as he jumped a little early and gets caught with a drop kick to the back. Clotheslines him. Bowen now keeping on the offensive. Picks him up. The former television champion knows what he's got to do. Misses the clothesline attempt, backbreaker, and the clothesline again follows through. Through to the inner leg. Oh, see that? He went for it and paid dearly as he sweeped and picked the ankle into that ankle lock, but unfortunately, too close to the ropes as Taz now does the deal. Quick cover now. One, two, no. The deal was not enough to seal it. As now, Hendricks trying to get in position for something else, but not able to get in position just yet. No, punch to the face by Blackwell. And ducks into the right, but caught him on that last one. Knee to the gut. Oh, the punches, the body blows. A lot of attacks on the body of Taz. It's going to make it really hard for him to keep his breath or even like maintain any sort of offensive position in this match if he can't breathe. Risky position here. Just snaps the knee. And now the shoulder getting snapped as well. Bowen maybe just covering his grounds here as much as he can. Of course, they're both bleeding from the head from the opening spot of the match. Of course, Taz bust Bowen open at the very beginning, and Bowen rebutted with a stomp to the back of the head that cut open his face when he hit the mat. Now, oh, the submission! The Kata Hashime! Locked in, clutch! No, elbow to the face by Blackwell to escape the submission hold. Bowen now, hammerlock, DDT. Two, no. Not enough there. Bowen springs off the bottom into the senton. Flurry of strikes is now Blackwell trying to stay on Taz here. Don't give him any time to breathe. Elbow to the face, though. Taz sends him into the buckle now. Big splash in the corner. Big forearm to the face. You can see him punching the temple directly in the spot where the blood has just poured from. Misses that chop as he gets blocked. Blackwell sends him into the corner. What does Bowen have in mind as he just slams him down? Quick cover attempted here. One, two, not quite enough. Face first into the corner again. An elbow to the face by Taz. Bringing him to the corner once again. Hendricks lifts him up. Bloody cross on Bowen. Cover. One, two, no. Oh! Hendricks tried to leap into that forearm and got met with a knee to the face. Fully just remembering exactly what happened at the start of the match. He was fully able to capitalize on that situation. Oh, and a kick to the head. Irish whip reverse sends him on the apron. Right forearm, and now caught him with a punch to the head. We're going to see that back suplex. Lifts him up and drops him on the edge of the ring. Hendricks just driving the knee into the mat. You know that's though it's a mat on the outside, it is a very thin mat. It still does not feel good to be thrown into that or dropped onto it. Hendricks now bringing Bowen around the steel steps, throwing him back in the ring. What's he got in mind here? Oh, ducks through and, oh, misses the clothesline. Drops him on the top rope, hanging him out to dry. As Blackwell now in danger. No, takeover. Keeping him grounded. With a guy like Taz Hendricks, though, keeping him grounded might not be the best solution. But Bowen's going to do whatever he can to keep him grounded and also stay on top of him with holds and strikes. Brings him into the corner. Or he got himself in the corner. He pulled him up for the backbreaker. And going to follow up with a second one. Just tosses him aside. Goes for the cover, though. You see, he hooked the leg, but he didn't put a lot of pressure on the shoulders, allowing Taz to be able to get out of the cover. And a big spine buster. Little disrespect. He stomped the shoulder. Now, wait a minute. Has him in an armbar. The triangle. A triangle armbar here is now Hendricks. Deadlift into the powerbomb. Not a lot of force behind it, but enough to break the hold. This is the clothesline. Hendricks fighting back as much as he can. Caught him with some rights of all kinds. Takes down into the bionic elbow to the head. Kick to the back. Hendricks with a right hand to the face. And again, blocked it that time. Turns him around. Taz has him. Kata Hashime. Kata Hashime. He's struggling. And he taps. Taz Hendrix submits Bowen Blackwell. Our second submission win for the night, and Taz Hendrix may have just punched his ticket for the road to success here in BPW as we take a short break. We'll be right back. All right, we're back. Our next match on the card. Singles action yet again. A television championship match, I believe. Don Blacksmith, former television champion, getting a shot at the championship again here tonight. Don Blacksmith, 5-3 in singles competition. Her opponent, the Tyrant, Alyssa Marceau, the television champion, 3-1. Marceau, they, like I said, are 3-1 in singles competition. Defeated by Alice Blackheart on Uprising, but able to defeat Alice on Crossfire to recover that loss. Alice, of course, took the championship off of Brittany Blake. Did I say Alice and Alyssa? Sorry if I did say the wrong name. of course, that television title, a long list of people to hold it, and not a singular one of them in the lineage of this specific version of the championship have been able to cash in at the championship for a shot at the title, the world title. No one has done it. Dawn Blacksmith could be the one to do it if she could defeat Alyssa Marceau here. There you see the champion. Gonna hand off the title to our official. Dawn sent into the corner immediately here as Dawn with an elbow, though. Alyssa with a rounding kick, a bunch of kicks here, just landing. Super kick to the gut. Not so super for Blacksmith, and now an elbow to the chest. Marceau, a very dominant competitor. They don't call them the tyrant for nothing. Blacksmith continuing to fight and throw some heavy offense at Marceau, but we'll see how much that gains momentum for her as she hits that knee. So went for an overhead, but Blacksmith able to reverse, sends them into the rope, or sorry, over the ropes. My mistake. I think it's better that we don't see what's going on here because it's obviously brutal. All you see is the head flying back and forth as we hear the impact of what I presume to be headbutts, and we're going to hear it again. So back in the ring as Blacksmith sends them in, but misses that up kick, or the not up kick, sorry, the knee lift. What I meant to say. I was trying to find a way to say the same thing, but in a different way. Marceau misses the roundhouse, gets caught, collar and elbow, boot to the gut. Blacksmith now charges into that flying neck breaker. Line again. Rolls into the senton. Springboard moonsault, the BME cover. One. Ooh, only a one count off the moonsault. We saw a couple of matches ago, someone went off a moonsault. Will not do the trick for Marceau. Boot to the chest, and now Dawn going to the top rope here. Looking to go coast to coast on Alyssa Marceau. But covered by Blacksmith. Only a one count. Really was quick for all of us, too. Irish whip into the corner as Don goes for the legs, but gets caught here with a knee and sent into the buckle. And now wrapped up in the rope here. Double knees to the stomach. They're not done. Deadlift into the side slam there. Really working on the body of Don Blacksmith. Elise Marceau is aggressive here, not wanting to lose that TV championship. And this is a long jump. With an awesome splash, Marceau. Blacksmith just taking a beating in this match. Smash into the corner, sends aside. Now locks in the Cobra Clutch into a crossface. Don able to break out of it with some elbows here. Body blow, takes the kicks everywhere around. Double stomp to the back. Power bomb flips into the final flash. Speaking of kicks, all super kick. Alyssa just cleaning their boots, charges in, rolls out of the way, turns her around, goes behind, no. An attempt was made, boot to the gut by Blacksmith, and two. The flatliner, cover, one, two, no. The ref took a little longer than I was expected to actually start counting. Had the ref started sooner, that could have been a three, the leg drop. Super kick. Alyssa staggered into the corner, no, knee to the gut. Marceau chopped to the chest. Collar and elbow now tying her up in the ropes again for another knee drop. And an assault being made here. Wrist clutched and drops the knees on the back. Followed with another one of these big side slams. Marceau showing an incredible amount of dominance. I cannot stress it up again and again and again. There is a reason for the nickname. It is less a nickname, but more of a title. Alyssa Marceau is the tyrant for a reason. That forearm strike just landed. Once again, the kicks are flying. The slap to the face. Oh, the crescent kick. Driving her head into the mat, and now just driving the boot into the stomach. This is starting to become too much. Irish whip into the ropes, pop up kick to the stomach, and Marceau not wasting any time, heading up to the top. Big elbow drop, cover, one, two, no. Luthes press and the strikes just right to the head. Not letting up on the offense. Blacksmith dodges the kick. They both wildly throw strikes, but Blacksmith so far recovering quite well. Big heel, not heel hook, sorry. Big Enziguri. Face first into the buckle now. Blacksmith with a chop, setting them up on the top. Deep to the face though. One, two, no. Blacksmith in trouble. Marceau, another slam on the mat hard. Uh-oh. Alyssa hangs her up to dry. Off the rope. Oh, the knee to the head. Marceau to the top. Awesome splash. Cover. One, two, three. The TV champion retains. I believe Alyssa Marceau has broken the record for defenses already. But I don't want to say that too definitively just in case I'm wrong, but this Women's Television Championship has had a lot of holders, and Alyssa not going to be just another holder. As they raise the championship and triumph as we move on. To our next match, tag team action. Parker Grant with the blonde hair and Kenji with the no hair. Former world champion in VPW, Kenji Urai, and Parker Grant, still relatively new. He took some time off of that knee injury. As you see, he's wearing the knee brace. Kenji and Parker 0-2 in tag division. In the tag division, sorry. And their opponents here tonight, representing the Black Lotus. I know the nameplate won't say that because I forgot to change it, but that's what it says in my note. So Black Lotus it is. Peligro in front, Ray Lethal, former television champion in his own right, making their way to the ring here on Future Foundation episode 57. By the way, this is our co-main event for the night. Our main event, Bad Amy versus Diana Thunder. Diana making her return after winning that VPW championship and being allotted a little bit of time to recover after Kingdom and the championship win. Start things off, Ray Lethal being lifted up in the air by Kenji with a brainbuster. Kenji with a belly-to-belly. Lethal being shot down to the mat there. Urai very smart in the plan he's got to keep the big man down. But unfortunately, he made the not-so-smart decision to let Parker Grant take a turn in the ring here. Parker Grant caught by Ray Lethal, dropped with a suplex here. Just stomping on the hand, doing absolute damage to that hand as well, I should say. Nice roundhouse kick there to the head. Cover almost got a three there. Now, to my recollection, which it varies quite a bit, I don't think any of these four have had any sort of interactions with each other outside of this matchup, which makes it an interesting match since they don't have a whole lot of experience facing one another. Caligro charges, and we're going to see him get sent into his own corner by Parker Grant here. Grant gets caught with an elbow, though, by Caligro, who grabs a hold of him. He's going to take him to the other corner. Face first into the buckle, he sends him onto the middle rope here. Caligro now springboards up and to the outside with a drop kick. Crosses the legs overhead, and look at the angle on his neck. A lot of damage being done with that hold. Oh, and a cheap shot at Kenji, making him pay for it. In return is Parker Grant. Northern Light suplex by Grant. Grant now has him. Slams him down. And a leg drop. Kenji with a running knee lift there. Sends Caligro, Caligro sends him into the corner. Hip toss, cartwheels through, and a knee to the face of Uri. Follows with that suplex. Ray Lethal now getting tagged in as gets a hold of Kenji, sends him into the ropes, takes him down with a knee to the gut. Again, a former television champion versus a former world heavyweight champion here. Kenji, of course, won the world heavyweight championship when we had our first brand split, defeating Brandon Alexander for that championship back in 2019. Snapmare takedown into the next snap. Parker Grant makes his way into the match once again. Goes behind. Ripcord knee to the chin. Oh my god, a big cross body. Takes him out of the ring with him. And into the steps as well. Parker Grant doing a lot of damage to Ray Lethal, which is surprising considering the vast size difference between the two. You'd think it'd be going the other way around. Parker Grant charges for the knee strike and using that knee brace possibly as a weapon. The referee can't stop him from doing so because it's technically a necessary thing to have as he gets caught here. Power slam onto the mat. Peligro watches on as Parker Grant reverses Ray Lethal's move. Boot to the gut. DDT busting open Ray Lethal, who gets the tag. Peligro catches Grant. Sends him over. No, pulls him back. Knee to the face. Quick cover attempted. Almost hit his own partner as he missed that. He thought he'd still be in place. Parker, smart enough to get out of the way, sets him on the rope. Taste of his own medicine. Springboard to the outside. Drop kicks him. Quick cover attempted now. One, two, and a breakup at two by Lethal. Backslide driver by Parker Grant. He's going to head up to the top rope here. Diving Meteora on Peligro. Drops the knee again, but this time nobody home. Peligro caught him. Sends him into the ropes here. Misses his clothesline to follow it. Continuing to miss his offense as Peligro sent into the... Oh, the elbow to the face. Ray Lethal now. Big man caught him with a sling blade. Rolls through and a drop kick to Grant. He might have caught his own teammate there, but it temporarily stunned Parker Grant, who caught him with an arm drag cover. Count of two off the arm drag. Lethal caught him. Oh, the big punch to the face there. Of course, folks, if you are just tuning in, we got one more match after this, and then Justice Stone will speak about his year-long plus reign as VPW champion. Grant with a punch to the gut of Lethal. Sends him into the corner here. Charges. Nope. A nice fake out there. He had convinced me that he was going to go for it as he gets caught with an elbow. Lethal sends Grant across the ring now. We could see a tag move here by Lethal and Peligro. No. Oh, exploder high on the neck as he hit the buckle cover. One, two, no. Just kicking his head off there as he picks him back up. Into the corner now. Tag made by Peligro and Lethal. Double Irish whips him. And a big back body drop. A lot of height on that as now Peligro stomps the chest. Peligro springboard, forearm to the face. Keeping him down as every time he tries to roll for that tag, they've managed to stop him. Sends him back into the corner here. Sets him on the bottom, on the middle rope, springboards, and through his own teammate, hits that drop kick on Parker Grant. Peligro charges for the clothesline, sends him to the floor, and now sets his sights on Kenji. Sunset flip, powerbomb on the outside. Peligro taunts as he thinks he's got it covered. Parker Grant tried for the kick and gets stopped. Knee to the face. Poison Rana by Peligro. Cover now. One, two. No, just a two count. Sends him across the ring. That poison rana wasn't enough. Maybe whatever he has in mind here will be another drop kick through his partner once again. Spring off the middle, shooting star press, nobody home. He makes the tag to Kenji, but Kenji gets caught as soon as he enters the ring. Speaking of being caught, Canadian Destroyer. Cover. One, two, no. Peligro sends him to the corner here. No tag to be made. He's going straight for an attack. Sends him face first in the buckle. Clotheslines him out of the corner. Now he tags to Lethal. This could be it for Kenji. Pop up Samoan drop. One, two, no. Still not enough. Lethal needs to put an end to Kenji here. Sends him into the buckle. No, an elbow to the face by Kenji. And he's just throwing strikes everywhere. Left and right's taking Lethal down, and Parker Grant now tagged in. Caught once more. He thought he had him. Sends him into the buckle. Face first. Lethal stomping the hand, now tags to Peligro once again. Peligro charges. Oh, he ran out of the way of the strike. Smart decision, super kick. And the straitjacket German. Very clear rope break, but the referee says otherwise. Strong kick to the head, and now Peligro lifts him up for another kick. And again. Clothesline. Goes behind. Oh, the sleeper slam there. Go to the gut. Canadian Destroyer on Grant. Peligro's got this one. Oh, wait a minute. The referee's out. Kenji, in an effort to break up the pin, also broke the referee. Elbow to the face by Parker Grant. Kicks the knee. Off the ropes he goes. Oh, the knee to the back of the head. He must have noticed the referee was down. He knows he's just got to keep him down long enough for the referee to recover. There it is. He pins him, but Ray Lethal right there to break it. Speaking of breaking, I think he's trying to break his arm. Oh, my God. Ripcord, knee to the face. Goes around into the neck breaker. Parker now. Taste of their own medicine. Exploder into the corner. Quick cover attempted. Oh, come on, Parker. You really don't need to do this. Peligro still manages a kick out. Backslide driver. And Grant looks to tag out. Oh, and a big STO. Peligro, oh, and a headbutt too, Jesus. He's begging him for some fight. Four strikes, oh, and Lethal's taken out. Oh, Poligro, flurry of offense, sets him down to the buckle. Oh, the six. Poligro completely isolated, but still fighting with everything he's got. Springboard into the splash. Covers now, but Parker Grant right there to break up that pin. Face first into the top buckle once again. Poligro sends him in harder. What's he got in mind? Face. Oh, wait a minute. Punch to the kidney there. Kidney shots are a good way to get out of a position you don't want to be in. It's a hammer strikes to the top of the head. Poligro from the top. Avalanche poison Rana. But Kenji makes the tag. Oh, and he body shielded. DDT on Poligro. Kenji, with his last bit of effort he could send in that moment, used himself as a shield to make sure Parker could get in the ring safely. Is now lethal. Drop kick down. He's right back up. Look for the leg sweep. Gets caught. Goes after the arm and snaps the wrist. Big lethal splash. Cover. One, two, no. Just tosses this much smaller opponent around as Poligro getting back in the ring here. Dropkick, no, missed. Inverted DDT by Grant. Cover now. Only a two count. Surprised we haven't seen Parker head up top for that shooting star press just yet. However, he is going to set him on the middle rope again. The signature springboard drop kick to the head. Parker Grant goes for the cover. One and a breakup, as we saw Ray Lethal coming across the ring there. Not much of a surprise at all, as Parker could be thinking that shooting star press finally. What? Oh my! Double rotation! Moonsault cover! One, two, three! Parker Grant and Kenji Urai just picked up their first ever win as a tag team! And it's at the expense of Ray Lethal and Poligro! What an upset right there as we move on to our next match, our main event. Diana Thunder versus Bad Amy. Bad Amy, multiple-time world champion and a one-time television champion, making her way to the ring. And as she does so, I will be right back. I do apologize, but I will be right back. And I'm back as Diana Thunder in the ring here. Like I said, was allotted the time to recover after a hectic schedule for Kingdom into the championship win. Of course, winning the championship, the VPW Women's Championship, in the fastest match in VPW history at exactly 5 seconds. Moves out of the way of that attempt. Gets a right hand on Amy. Sets Amy on the ropes here. And I'm getting word right now that this match, though it was not advertised as such, it has just been made official. This is a VPW Women's Championship Eliminator match. Amy caught with that forearm smash. Diana with some heavy strikes. Going off the ropes here. Drops the knee, nobody home. Misses that second attempt at the leg drop as Diana, big shining wizard, but not getting enough of it. And now Amy making her pay with a poison Rana. Quick cover attempted. Bit of mind games on the opponent, really beating it into her head. Back and forth reversals, though to my knowledge they haven't had much interactions with each other. They do know each other very well because Amy has a long storied history here in VPW with that championship that Diana holds. And Diana, though she hasn't had as many matches as Amy has on VPW, her entire repertoire has been seen across multiple promotions. That's the leg sweep there. Irish whip into the ropes. Into the military press. Michinoku driver. Kick to the leg. No, it's blocked the strike. Getting some strikes of her own. And a heel hook to the face. Quick cover now. One. Only getting a one count. Amy sending Diana back to the mat and a kick to the body as Amy's just gonna smash her face into the apron there. Amy, of course, I believe a three-time BPW Women's Champion. Of course, like I said, one-time television champion. That television title being the only championship Amy has held in BPW that was not the World Championship. Amy knows what she's capable of, and she's going to allow her opponent the time to recover, to get back in the ring. And Diana, we've seen what she's capable of. Like I said, a five-second matchup to win the championship. But that could be what's causing the problems right now. Overconfidence of the champion. Diana off the ropes, jumping into the knee drop, connects once again. Elbow to the lower back. Continue to try for that offense on the lower back. Diana goes behind, German suplex, no! Amy went for that knee, gets caught with a forearm. They tried both trying to hit their special moves. And getting blocked, sunset flip over into the powerbomb. Diana now off the ropes, knee drop misses once again. Amy now has her on the ropes. Knife edge chop and tangles her knee in the rope, just putting a lot of torque on the knee. Oh, the DDT by Thunder. Cover. One, two, no. Not quite enough. Amy sends Thunder into the ropes to the knee lift. Oh, but Thunder rolling into the ropes. Very, very smart decision. However, not as smart was standing up on the outside. Caught with the dive on the floor. Diana back in the ring as Amy taking her time, trying to soak in the crowd's energy here, try to recover what has been lost. Amy's just going to keep circling like a shark ready to attack a vulture as she gets caught and sent back to the outside. Diana's going to give her the outside time she wants, but not alone, as now she's out here with her. Of course, you don't want to miss it. After this matchup, Justice Stone has requested and was granted his time to speak to celebrate 1 year plus as BPW World Champion, as Diana back in the ring and gets caught by Amy. And like I said at the top of the match, in case you haven't heard about this one, this is a eliminator matchup. If Amy is able to defeat Diana Thunder, she'll get a women's championship match in the near future. Oh, Kinshasa! One, two, no! We almost had to eat our own words there. Amy lifts up Diana, but a leg sweep takes her down. Snaps the shoulder, and I want to just say it again in case you weren't here earlier. MVH has challenged anyone and everyone for a shot at the Revolt Wrestling Network Championship at WrestleWars, an open challenge, an open contract. Anyone, anywhere can accept. As Amy picks up Diana Thunder, Noah reversal boot to the gut. Oh, the big forearm smash goes for the cover. One, two, no. Goes around, German suplex. One, two, no. Diana, hesitation, drop kick. Now off the ropes. Big knee drop again, scouted by Amy. The right fly, no, the forearm gets blocked. Irish whip into the corner to reverse. Amy sends her over the rope, and the knee to the face. Amy's not done. Charges for the leg drop. And a second one, this time it lands. The elbow drop to the lower back. Diana trying to recover some of that lost offense. Off the ropes. Knee drop. No, not happening again. Leg drop to the back of the head. Almost a famouser. Irish whip to the floor. Diana taking a good moment here. Do the damage on the outside. Amy, face first, into the ring again. We've seen it for multiple times this match. Sent into the steel, steps on the outside. The forearms followed by the X Factor. Cover here. One, two, no. Kick out at two by Diana. Power bomb by Amy into the knee strike. Amy's knees are devastating. Misses the leg drop. Off the ropes. Diana, knee to the face. Thunder now. Slam into the buckle. Toss aside. Going for the knee drop again. She's going to the well one too many times, or a dozen too many times, I should say. Though she's able to hit it on occasion, it has not been effective. Sent into the ropes now. Oh, the Kinshasa again. Cover. One, two, no. Still not enough. Amy sent across the ringside area. Amy's just going to take a moment here on the outside. Again, it's a mind game for Bad Amy. Just recover. Avoids the forearm smash. Both of them completely out here. Just temporarily, though. Count of 10 is Amy showing zero regard for the count. And zero regard for the head and neck of Diana Thunder as well. Oh, reversal by Thunder this time. Sends her across the ringside area. She returns back to the ring. Kicking towards her. Doesn't really hit it. But Diana made a mistake and is paying for it. Kinshasa, cover the champions down. 1, 2, 3. Bad Amy, we could be seeing her win the championship once again. Winning this eliminator match means she gets a shot at the championship in the future. We could be seeing a first ever four-time VPW Women's Champion. As we see Justice Stone flocked with just his best friends in the world, Jacob Wells and Aaron Stone. Let's hear what Justice Stone has to say.
A bit more than 5 years ago, I walked into VPW as a rookie. You know, I wasn't experienced in any company. You know, as far as I've always believed, I only got in just because they needed someone that night. And around this time, 5 years ago, I was world champion for the first time. And I carried this company on my back during one of the hardest times this company has ever seen. I made sure VPW got through to the other side. And for that, what was I rewarded with? 4 years without a world title. 4 years of having to fight my now best friend in the ring with me. 4 years of just constant downhill fights until I found who I was again. And now I've been walking through VPW as your champion for over 300 days. Not even 300 days. 365 days. You're world champion for over a year, and you know the only way me and Wells could celebrate properly is if I got Mr. Booze, Milk, and Cream, my former tag partner and now honorary Top Gun member, Aaron Stone. And the only thing I had left as a blemish on this run was my loss to Hunter. And everyone saw what happened the last time we fought. I have that win back. So as far as I'm concerned, that blemish is removed. And as we all want to know what's next, well, I don't know what's next, but I know me, Wells, and my favorite other Stone are gonna be here all night.
What is... Hunter's making his way to the ring here, or down to the stage at least, I don't know. He's got something to say about what's going on with Justice Stone here.
Hey guys, I don't mean to interrupt your little fun celebration you guys got going on in the ring right now, but I do have some things I need to say, and it's not to Jacob or the other Stone. I have something I need to say to the VPW World Champion in the ring right now, Justice Stone. Justice, you and I both know we went to war at Crossfire, and I was just inches away from becoming the VPW World Champion. I gotta say, at Crossfire, you were the better man. But don't forget that way back when, I was the better man when I pinned you in this very ring here in VPW. So, I have a little proposition to you, if you're not too much of a coward, to give me the chance. Why don't we, because we are one and one against each other here in VPW, you be the true fighting champion you claim to be, and we have one last match against each other to see who the better man is, me versus you, for the third time, for the VPW World Championship.
Look, Hunter, I don't know what you're trying to prove by coming out here and saying all that to me. All that you've done and proved to me is that you can't step up when it matters. You beat me when it meant nothing, but when you could have walked out with the world title around your waist, you failed. You failed yourself, and you failed everyone that wanted you to win. As far as I'm concerned, we're even. But we are in the middle of a celebration. And I've proved I'm not afraid of you. And I seem to have my two best friends in the whole world with me.
Oh no.
Two people that you also can't keep up with. So here's an idea. You want a rematch so bad. You're gonna need to earn it. And if I want to spend a match with my boys and show you that you don't have what it takes, why don't we do it in the match that I haven't lost at? You see, Hunter, I like to be aggressive in the ring. I like to fight. But just because my main aspect is in the ring doesn't mean I don't like to get my hands dirty. So if you can somehow manage to find two people that are willing to step in the ring with not just me, but Aaron Stone and TV champ Jacob Wells, well, then at the next pay-per-view, if you and whoever these friends are can beat us in War Games,
oh my,
I'll give you your rematch. World title on the line, no one allowed at ringside. But if you lose, you're done with the world title until it's not on my shoulder anymore. And by the looks of it, we're nearing 400 days at this point. It's gonna be a while. So what do you say, Hunter?
You know what, Justice? I actually really like that idea. And I can't wait for my team to embarrass you at Wrestle Wars as you're locked in a steel cage with nowhere to run. And after we beat you at Wrestle Wars, well, you better start saying your goodbyes to your precious championship because it is coming home with the gentleman.
You know, that's the one thing I've always liked about you, Hunter. Back against the wall. No clear good end in sight. Only pain. And you still took the match just because you still think you have a chance. VPW, make it official. And Hunter, I've been skeptical if you're going to even find two people that want to be in the ring with us. But at this point, let's see if you even make it to the pay-per-view.
Whoa, Holt, what does he mean by that? Oh, you've got to be kidding me! We're going to have war games, we're going to have Wrestle Wars officially, but Stone and Wells are going to make sure that he doesn't make it as Jacob Wells and Aaron Stone charging up the ramp to confront Hunter. This is a 2-on-1 attack. Oh, Hunter Quinn! Hunter Quinn's here and he takes out Jacob Wells and Aaron Stone! Hunter Quinn's not going to allow this 2-on-1 beatdown. Wait a minute! Who is that? Kill switch! It's Stalker! Former X Division champion Stalker just attacked Jester Stone. He's going for the cock blockster. Stone, no, he gets out of the ring. He avoids the danger and escapes for now. Stalker is back and he's standing side by side with the Hunters. We've got our Wrestle Wars main event. Justice Stone with Jacob Wells and Aaron Stone versus Hunter Quinn and Stalker. We'll see you on the next show. Thank you for watching.